Employees face various problems and challenges on a daily basis. Such issues affect their work efficiency. In order to overcome this barrier, counseling at work is required. This video highlights the different types of counseling that are made available to the employees at work. Before we proceed, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. That little notification bell will also help you to be always informed about our latest updates. Some people find it difficult to cope in the hectic corporate life. Their efficiency will get affected if they aren't provided timely assistance. There are various forms of counseling that can be made available to the employees to help them get solutions to their problems. Good companies appoint experienced counselors to tackle the problems of the employees. So, here are the various forms of counseling that are provided by a company. Number 1. Directive counseling. Directive counseling involves talking with the employee, knowing what the real issue is, and together deciding the way out of the situation. This form of counseling at work mostly involves giving advice, reassurance, and communicating. This method works best in simple issues such as lack of motivation, inability to do the work on time, consistent tardiness, etc. Directive counseling is used to help the employees pay attention to the problem before disciplinary action comes into force. This type of counseling values the views of the employees more and helps to keep up their spirit. It may also be carried out by experienced people, who are not professional counselors. Such people may be the direct superiors to whom the person reports to. Number 2. Non-directive counseling. Non-directive counseling works in more complicated issues and situations such as performance difficulties due to exogenous factors, personal conflict, poor communication, etc. This type of counseling needs active listening on part of the counselor. The counselor in this method tries to connect and empathize the employee as much as possible. He or she explains the effects of such problem on the team and suggests necessary precautions and steps. The employee here is encouraged to share his/her feelings without fear or embarrassment. It is one of the types of counseling where the employee is pressed and motivated to share his/her inner conflicts. These are relevant while providing non-directive counseling at work. Number 3. Participative counseling. Participative counseling is more expensive because it tries to overcome the limitations of directive and non-directive counseling. This form of counseling at work aims to arrive at the middle ground by following the footsteps of the previous two methods. Participative counseling aims to establish a counselor-counselee relationship where a cooperative solution is reached to find the way out of the problems. Both the parties, here, mutually apply their conscience, knowledge, and logic to find a viable solution. This process also helps the employee to confront his/her own faults. So, this is a form of counseling that merges the elements of both directive and non-directive counseling. Number 4. Disciplinary counseling. Disciplinary is a type of counseling in which there is a personal interaction between the counselor and the employee. In this, the employee is motivated and helped to abide by the code of conduct in the organization. It may focus on certain workplace incidents or something related to performance appraisal. A particular action by the employee might have been identified by the supervisor, and disciplinary action has to be initiated. In such situation, this type of counseling at work will help to correct the approach of the employee by talking. Counselors in charge are responsible to help the concerned worker acknowledge his/her faults and motivate him/her to adhere to the rules. Number 5. Personal counseling. Sometimes the employees struggle to perform their work efficiently due to personal problems. Personal counseling is one of the most important forms of counseling, which helps an individual to find out ways to tackle personal life issues. Many a time employees have marital issues, financial issues, health issues, etc. All these problems collectively hinder the growth of the individual. Therefore, effective counseling at work can help such employees to overcome these problems and concentrate on their personal life and professional life in a better way. These were some important counseling methods. Employees can get timely help and assistance with the help of counselors. The role of counseling has improved a lot in the recent times. With people becoming more stressful, help is needed in every field. If you like this video, then don't forget to subscribe to our channel and share it further with your friends. Waiting to hear your views in the comments section.